21 years old, severe hair thinning. Had 3 PRP treatments done. Had best results which went away in a month. What's next? Hi, I've been suffering from hair thinning since September 2014. I had a fungal infection on the scalp and I had my roots damaged in early 2014 by cosmetic treatments like hair straightening, etc. The fungal infection is still in the scalp. In the pictures, the results which is shown is after 4 weeks of PRP treatment, which filled all the gaps in the scalp. But I started Finasteride with 100 milligrams of fluconazole once a week, which shed all the hair I gained. Now I look the same as the first picture. Need suggestions.
Thank you for your question. You're 21 years old, and with the photos and the history that you submitted, you're describing a scenario where you've had some hair thinning, and initially you also had to deal with a fungal infection of the scalp, and that you had lost some hair, and after undergoing 3 PRP or platelet-rich plasma treatments, you appear to have some improvement. However, in more recent history, you've been placed on 100 milligrams of fluconazole to take weekly and finasteride, and you state that the hairs have fallen out because of those drugs. So you're asking what to do next. Well, I can give you some guidance as to my thoughts about your situation. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon practicing in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. And I am also the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system we've developed to treat hair loss, which does involve the use of platelet-rich plasma as well as acellular matrix, and has been a very successful treatment as a non-surgical alternative for hair loss. So I think that what we have to define is the causes of your hair loss and then decide on the solutions. First of all, having a fungal infection can have a negative impact on your hair. Fungal infections are often difficult to manage, do require both topical and systemic treatment, which appears you to be getting. I would agree that there is maybe some degree of hair loss associated with a fungal infection, but at the same time, what it appears to be is that you also have a genetic male pattern hair loss, also called androgenetic alopecia. Now, the challenge for you was that, of course, you went through the PRP injections, which appeared to help you, and then the hair became fell off or fell out. And so you're maybe making the error of correlating the initiation of finasteride and fluconazole with the causation of the hair loss. To get some concept as to the challenge of with hair loss, with finasteride, what you're doing is you are inhibiting an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. This is the enzyme responsible for converting testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Dihydrotestosterone follicles or sensitive follicles will thin. Therefore, when you diminish it, it actually will slow down the thinning process. And that's an important distinction. Finasteride doesn't necessarily stop hair loss. It actually just slows it down very effectively in many people. Unfortunately, a lot of our younger patients and a lot of patients in general who come to us don't want to take finasteride because of concerns of long-term sexual side effects. Now, it is important that you do manage your fungal issues, but at the same time, there is a little bit of a window here where you may have some benefit from a treatment that is a little bit different from the PRP. As far as my experience is concerned, platelet-rich plasma, which we use a lot in our practice, we use it for fine lines and wrinkles, we use it for acne scars, we use it for scar revision, we use it for complexion improvement. We love using platelet-rich plasma. We use it for dark circles under the eyes. But in my experience, platelet-rich plasma for hair loss has a short-term benefit. This is reflected by my observations on patients who come to us. People who have come to us after they've had platelet-rich plasma injection will say that I went for an injection every month for about 4 months, and although I may have seen, I saw some improvement, I just didn't know if I could keep doing that. In our practice, hair regeneration has been our solution for long-term treatment of male pattern and female pattern hair loss. We do use platelet-rich plasma as part of our treatment, but we use something called extracellular matrix. Now, this combination appears in our experience with over 5 years of data and hundreds of patients who come to us from around the world. With one single session treatment, we've been able to, for the majority of patients, 99% for both men and women, stop the progression, initiate or reactivate growth of hairs that are not growing, and have thinning hairs become thicker. Now, we do customize the treatment, so there are people that will do maybe a second treatment in the second year, but overall, that system has been able to be successful for people who aren't on any other medication, and in particular for men who are on finasteride or don't want to take finasteride. Finasteride, by the way, also is beneficial for approximately 60% of men. That means 40% will not respond. If you are 21 and you are undergoing hair thinning, then you have a very aggressive pattern. You've started at a younger age and you're losing hair relatively quickly, which means that you have a limited window to do something that will at least treat the hair loss. I think taking the finasteride is a reasonable step, but at the same time, you may want to learn more about a treatment like hair regeneration to get you to a place where you can maximize your results. There are patients of ours who will take finasteride, and we will combine that with a hair regeneration treatment. The fascinating thing about hair regeneration is that we've basically uncovered and revealed that there's more to hair loss than just DHT. And the fact that it works for women as well, where DHT is not considered a factor that causes female pattern hair loss, opens up even new avenues for treatment that for us has been very, very gratifying. So again, understand that you may be making an error in correlation and causation, that the finasteride and fluconazole are not causing the hair loss. It might be more of the wearing off of the effect of platelet-rich plasma and the concurrent presence of a fungal infection. You have to see whether or not finasteride will be adequate to stabilize your hair loss, but you also may want to consider a treatment like hair regeneration. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.